what you need. The first thing you need is your motherboard. Here's my motherboard, and I've got my Bluetooth on it that will help me connect to my tab. You can use any of these 6 ports to connect the sensors and the motor. So the next thing, of course, is a motor. But this time, we're going to use the pump motor. Here I've got my pump motor. This portion must be immersed into water. Every time you switch on the pump motor, water travels through this pipe and flows out. The next thing I need is a sensor. For this project, I'm going to use the IR sensor. So here's my IR sensor, and I've got a cable to connect them together. Now let's go ahead and look at the connections. Grab your motherboard and choose any of the 6 ports to connect your IR sensor. Now for your pump motor, choose any of the 2 ports, M1 or M2. I'm going to use M1. Make sure you remember the port number so that you can program your app accordingly. Once you've connected the IR sensor and the motor, you're done connecting. Go ahead and place this inside your structure and start building an app. So here's the smart tap that I've built. I've got my IR sensor here that will detect when I place my hand under the tap, my motherboard, and my pump motor inside this cup. So let me quickly switch on my motherboard and connect it to my app. Select my motherboard and it says connected. Now, let me show you how this works. So as you can see, every time I place my hand in front of the tap, the water flows from the pipe and goes into the bowl. Can you think of any other project you could build using the pump motor and another sensor? Well, I'll tell you something that my friend built. My friend built a firefighter using the pump motor and the temperature sensor. Could you come up with any more ideas? Let us know in the comments. So this is how you can use the pump motor with the IR sensor. Let's start designing our app. To start, log on to www.stemdesi.in and start designing. The first thing to do is add Bluetooth connectivity. So I'm quickly going to add a Bluetooth client and a list picker. If you're wondering how to do this from scratch, go ahead and watch the Bluetooth introduction video. Now it's time to add some Cutie Pie Mega Blocks. From the palette on the left, grab the Pump Motor Cutie Pie Mega Block and add it onto your screen. Make sure you give it Bluetooth connectivity and a port number. The next thing to do is add an infrared sensor. You'll again find this in the palette on the left called Cutie Pie Mega Blocks. After you drag and drop it, don't forget to add Bluetooth connectivity and give it a port number. The last thing to do is add a notifier. Once you've done this, go ahead and program your app. To start programming your app, the first thing to do is grab the Bluetooth connectivity blocks from the backpack on the top right corner of your screen. So here's my before picking block and my after picking block. Once you've added the Bluetooth connectivity blocks, go ahead and program your sensor and motor. So grab the on change event handler for your IR sensor. Once you've done this, add an if then else block. Use the get IR procedure for your IR sensor to check the value of the IR sensor. Every time the IR sensor detects a value, it turns true. So, if the IR sensor detects a value of true, go ahead and use the rotate speed direction procedure to program your motor. Give it a speed of 150 and a direction of true. You could also give a speed of 255, but the flow of water will be very forceful. You can adjust the speed of the motor according to what you'd like to build. If the value is false, then give a speed of 0 and any direction of your choice. Since the speed is 0, the direction does not matter, So this could be true or false. I'm gonna give it true. So once you've added all these blocks, you're done programming your app. Go ahead, save and build your app. And see how your smart app works.